Time it is, boys and girls, young and old alike. It's time for another sermon from, another exciting sermon from Super Sermon Dave, man. Up in the air, up and away. Up in the air as the birds are playing, it's Super Sermon Dave, man. Hey guys, David Stanton, 5-8-2020 is here for another sermon that I wrote years ago and put on trucking hotline or trucking line to preach to truck drivers. Trying to make these sermons exciting. Some of them I'm reading to you and some of them I come up with and just preach them on here. But I'm just kind of reading some of my sermons right now and hope you get blessed, all you little super Sermon Dave man stirs out there and adults alike. So this one's called Be a Laborer With Me for Jesus. So I'm going to go ahead and read to you. So be blessed. Let's see. Okay, Matthew 28:19. Go therefore and teach all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. We have to go out to the highways and byways to reach the lost, dying and hurting people. Some and even a lot of them won't step foot inside of a church. Some have been hurt in church. Some think that they have sinned too bad or too much to be worthy or to step inside of a church. Some think churches are full of hypocrites. Church is like a hospital for the sick. You will meet all kinds of people there with real life sin issues. Matthew 9:37 says, Then saith he unto his disciples, The harvest truly is plenteous, but the laborers are few. Matthew 9:38 says, Pray therefore the Lord of the harvest that he will send forth laborers into his harvest. Are you willing to step out of your comfort zone and let God use you to make a difference in people's lives? To let God use you to save souls for Jesus Christ? Just think of all the people you could have reached. Be a fellow laborer with me and shine your light in this dark and dying world. People, the Bible says that now is the hour. Today is the day of salvation. You can simply reach out to your neighbor and witness to them. They could be a dying soul on their way to the devil's hell. By you reaching out to them with the gospel of Jesus Christ and his plan of salvation, they could be rescued from Satan's grip and translated to the kingdom of Jesus Christ. Salvation is for everyone who will believe in Jesus Christ and him crucified on the cross for our sins, buried and raised on the third day. Jesus can alone forgive sins. Confucius, Buddha, and Muhammad all have died and never rose on the third day like Jesus did. They went up for judgment. For the Bible says after death, judgment. They can't forgive sins. Jesus was the perfect sacrifice for our sins. He was complete fulfillment of our sin penalty. He lives to give us forgiveness and new life in him. The first Adam is in the Garden of Eden sinned, and so there became the fall man. Man had to use sacrificial animals to God to cover their sins. Their sins were only covered when Jesus came into the world and died on the cross. He became the last Adam and became the ultimate and last sacrifice for all sin. When he died for our sins, there was no need for any other sacrifice to forgive sins. Jesus completed it. He not only covered our sins, but washed them away with his blood. It's kind of like when you sin, Jesus' blood is poured out on that sin and washes it away. Or it's like a single drop of blood that washes away our sins. We want to make a difference in this world for Jesus Christ, right? Do you want soul saves? Do you want what Jesus wants? That's what Jesus wants. We need to have a heart after Jesus. We need to do his will. You don't have to be called to the ministry as preachers being behind a pulpit, because we are all preachers and ministers when it comes to witnessing to people. Yes, some people will turn you away and some will persecute you, but some will receive the message of the gospel with joy. If you are persecuted for witnessing about Jesus Christ, remember that the prophets were before you. You are truly blessed. Rejoice, because great is your reward in heaven. They are not persecuting you, but they are persecuting Jesus. Jesus will baptize you with the Holy Ghost and fire. If your life is ever on the line for Christ, which it very well could be in these end times, don't deny Jesus. He said, if you deny me before men, I will deny you before my Father which is in heaven. Paul said in the New Testament, to live is Christ, to die is gain. Some of us will die and are dying for Jesus, but great is our reward in heaven. To be a martyr, I'm sure, is a great honor. Stephen was stoned to death for preaching about Jesus. He said that he saw heaven opened up and Jesus standing at the right hand of him again, of the Father, before he died. Can you imagine what an honor it would be to see Jesus standing up for you? Jesus today is standing up for you. Will you stand up for him? Matthew 24 says that the gospel shall be preached to the ends of the earth, then the end shall come. Let's do our part and fulfill God's great commission. Let's win souls for Jesus Christ. I'm in it. Are you? What's our mission in life? Are we just doing the everyday grind, trying to get ahead without focusing on the real importance of God? We need to change our perspective and priorities. Of course, we have to work hard, but Jesus wants us to witness to people. There are 365 days in a year. Imagine if one just witnessed, or if you witnessed to just one person a day. Imagine if 365 people get saved or at least witness to. We are only here for a short time. Let's fulfill the great commission of Jesus Christ. In Jesus' name. Everybody, I want you to know that I wrote this message years ago. It's about called Be a Laborer with Me for Jesus. Are you going to be a laborer with me for Jesus? This world is coming to an end. Jesus is coming back soon and very soon. We'll be caught up in the air to meet him. Then Christ shall rise first. 1 Thessalonians chapter 4. We got to be ready. We got to start planting seed in people's lives. We got to start making influence in their lives and be waterers of laborers that came before, and also laborers that people water or just reap the harvest. And I just want to pray for you right now and encourage you. Dear Heavenly Father, God, I come in your name and I pray for people out there that are Christians, that they would come to you, Lord, and they would have a hunger and desire for mankind, to reach mankind, to do the great commission that we're commanded to do. It's a commandment to reach the lost and take away from their busy life and make time and put room in there for especially you, but then also for reaching others. Lord Jesus, I pray you encourage us and inspire us and motivate us. And I thank you, Father. And I rebuke all your spirits of fear and timidity and lack of and thinking that they can't do it all for them in Jesus' name. I want you to know, just talking about Jesus, just saying how he loves you and died for your sins, and talking about your testimony and what he did for you and how he brought you out. He got me out of drinking and drugs and partying, running from the law, and doing drugs, cigarettes, drinking, drugs, I mean, crime, you know, psych wards, you know, juvie. I did a lot of bad things, you know, but God brought me out. And I tell people how I had overdosed with drugs and God brought me back. If I wouldn't call on Jesus, I wouldn't be here. You know, I could put my testimony on here sometime, y'all. But tell them how Jesus brought you out of this mess and gave you peace and all that. I just encourage you to be a fellow laborer with me for Jesus. You got this. God's got you. And if you're not saved, Jesus loves you. He died on the cross for your sins and rose from the dead 3 days later so you can be saved. All you have to do is call upon the name of the Lord and you'll be saved from sin, from hell. He loves you. He will use you for his glory and he'll give you peace like you've never had before. He said, peace, peace to them afar off and to him that is near, say the Lord, and I will heal them. If you're far from God, you can be near to him. Draw near to him. He'll draw near to you and he'll give you peace far off or near. Jesus loves you. I hope you like my sermons, and subscribe and like and comment if you like. Comment if you got some prayer requests or whatever, and subscribe whatever you want to say. God bless you. And this has been a sermon from Super Sermon Dave Man. Hope you all have a great day. Jesus loves you and I do in Christ. Bye-bye.